Welcome all, Associate Professor, SIRT MBA, The Sage Group. Today, I am in front of you to discuss with you the topic Negotiation from the subject Organization Behavior, Unit 4, MBA Second Sem. Now, the question arises, what is negotiation? Now, negotiation is the process of give and take, exchange among persons aimed at resolving problems or conflicts. Basically, it is a process of give and take, which is exchange among persons aimed at resolving the problems or conflicts. And basically, this term is being used in the organization. You might have heard another word, that is bargaining. So normally in the normal life or in a layman's language, we normally use these two words synonymously. But there is a difference between negotiation and bargaining. Bargaining is basically an exchange of favors or trading activity. While we are going to the vegetable market or you are going for the purchase of your clothes and whatever, at that very particular moment when you are doing the negotiation of the prices of the product, so that is actually known as bargaining. But when you go for an interview and when you bargain for your salary, when you negotiate for your salary or a profile, that is known as negotiation, which is the process of give and take. Something you have to give and the other one has to take it. So that is the process of negotiation. And negotiation plays a very important role in any kind of organization, whether it is a large scale organization or a small scale organization, because this process helps you to resolve various kind of problems or conflicts occur in any kind of organization. Because of this word negotiation, we have trade unions in our organizations which help us to negotiate between the workers as well as the management. Now see, what is the difference between bargaining and negotiation? The distinction goes like this. Bargaining is about focusing on who is right. It's a competitive and win-lose relationship. Whereas negotiation, on the other hand, is about focusing on what is right rather than who is right. So it is a cooperative and win-win relationship where both parties gain something from the transaction. So basically, in the negotiation process, our motive is that both the parties will win some or the other part. It should not be like that one would win and the other would lose, as happened in bargaining. So this is the basic difference between bargaining and negotiation. Though we are using these two terms synonymously, but there is this difference between that which you must learn about. Now, the another is, what is the negotiation criteria? The first criteria is that the issue must be negotiable. The issue on which you are negotiating the things, or the parties which you are negotiating on the particular thing, so that issue should be negotiable. It is not like that the issue is like which is not negotiable and you are sitting on the table to negotiate that very particular issue. And second is, negotiators must be interested in both giving and taking. It is the must or the very important condition that before sitting on the negotiation table, both the parties should be interested in that. It is not like that the one party is sitting just for the sake of the other party, but he is not interested in negotiating or giving or taking mode. So both the parties should be in giving and taking mode. The third and the important criteria is that the parties must trust each other and the negotiation process. Until and unless both the parties trust each other and the negotiation process, the result cannot be good for both of them. If they are not trusting each other, so they believe that the result or the solution for that very particular negotiation is not fit for them. So it is the must criteria that parties must trust each other. Now, these are the negotiation characteristics, or you can say these are the features of negotiation, that there must be two or more parties. Obviously, negotiation can be done if there are two parties present. Then, before negotiation, there should be a conflict of interest between the parties. Only then the negotiation process can start. If there is no conflict of interest among the parties, so no negotiation can be done. Then it should be a voluntary process. Both the parties should be interested, as we have done in the criteria, that both the parties should be interested in giving and taking criteria. then another point give the same thing, that is, there should be a notion of give and take among both the parties, then mutual fulfillment of needs. There should be the feeling among the parties that there, after the solution of the negotiation, there is a mutual fulfillment of their needs, means both the parties would be in win-win situation. Then we can use certain strategies to influence the other party, but those strategies should be like that, should not be infeasible. There should be feasible strategies, they should not harm the other party, but you can use the strategies to influence the other party. It can be any kind of thing in their benefit, anything. So you can use any of the strategy. We'll just do the strategies in the further slides of ours. Now there is certain step in negotiation, so we have to follow a few steps or the process of negotiation. The first step is we have to prepare for the negotiation. So we have to prepare both the parties for the negotiation, and both the parties has to come up with their points. They have to be well prepared with the data, with the facts and with the figures, and then they have to come on the table. Then there should be a relationship between two the parties, relationship of trust, which we have already done. Then exchanging information or first offer, they have to exchange information with each other, and the information which they used to share with each other should be transparent and factful. That should not be any kind of fraudulent information which they are sharing with each other. It should be very fruitful information, or it should be real information. Then persuasion, yes, they can use the influence power of theirs. They can persuade the other party, they can motivate the other party to just stick to your point or to just negotiate on your terms and conditions. Then concessions, obviously, if you want to come up with the win-win situation, so you need to give certain concessions to the other party, or maybe the other party should connect with those concessions. Only then the negotiation can be possible. Then after, at the last, if both the parties agreed on that very particular concessions or terms or conditions, then the agreement would be there among both the parties and the negotiation process will be successful. Now, another are the strategies for negotiation which we are talking about in the previous slides. So the strategies for negotiations are these four strategies. First is the flinch, the deadline, the nibble, which is known as bite, and the fourth one is the concession. The first and the very simple strategy is the flinch. Flinch means drawback at initial proposal, which is very simple, that you just draw back at initial proposal, but this is not the solution. Then the deadline could be given to produce results. If the other party is not able to produce the result, then the deal is yours. Then the nibble and bite, when you just get something extra that is sought. It can be small or big, anything that can be a strategy which you can offer to the other party. Then the concession, which you can get or you can offer to the other party that is valuable to the other person, little or no value to you, that can be offered to the other party. So these are the four strategies which you can use for doing the negotiation successful. Now there are various models of succession negotiation, so we'll do that one by one. These are three models of negotiation. One is competitive model, as the name suggests, where the one party win and the other party lose. Cooperative, where both the parties will get something, win-win situation. Problem solving, which is basically to solve one of the issue or the problem of any of the organization. So these are the three important models of negotiation. We'll do it one by one. The first one is competitive. So see the various characteristics or the components of competitive model. The first one is adversarial, contemplates win or lose, as the name suggests, competitive. So it is one party will win and the other party will lose. Then in this competitive model, there would be high initial demand, fewer small concessions because everybody would like to win. Then threats can be there, arguments can be there because one party obviously wants to win against the other party. The results could be high. Highly economical because one party is winning and the other party is losing, and whatever the other party is losing, the winning party is getting that very particular thing. So obviously high economic results. So this is the competitive model. Now there are certain advantages and disadvantages of this competitive model. So one of the advantage, as we have discussed in the previous slide, that is high economic results. Whereas disadvantages can be lack of sufficient information, because if the situation is competitive where only one party has to win, so there could be chances that the other party will not disclose the whole information or the right information in front of the other party. So there could be the situation of sufficient information is lacking. Then may ignore relationship issues. Obviously, if there is a competition between the two parties, so there is no such kind of a relationship between the two parties, that can be ignored totally. Now, the second important model is cooperative model. As the name suggests, it is win-win situation. Which starts reasonable opening offers and arguments. The one party will give the offer to the other party, and the other party may or may not accept that very particular offer. But that offer is that the other party would also win something based on perceptions of fairness and justice. Basically, as compared to competitive model, this is quite fair and justice model. Unilateral concessions will be given to encourage reciprocation, so that the other party will definitely accept your proposal and come to the negotiation. There are certain advantages and disadvantages of this model also. So the advantage is that this model is more durable because this is not competitive and there is no lack of relationship. It strengthens the relationship between the two parties. It is less likely to break down because in this both the parties is getting something, so it ends with a fruitful solution. Disadvantages can be lack of objective standards, may be less satisfying and difficult to justify. Why it is less satisfying? Because maybe it could be a position that the other party will not get that much which it expected to get. So in that very particular case, he may not be that much satisfied, but the situation is win-win. That is the major advantage of this very particular model. Now the third model is problem solving, which is again an important model to be done. So this is basically a joint effort to meet parties' interest. Both the parties will do the joint effort so that their interest can be served and the problem can be solved properly. It can be done in a particular sector. It can be done in a particular organization between the departments. Anyway, then what are the advantages? The advantages are many, including improved relationships, communication could be good, legitimacy will be good, and the risk could be less, and analysis can be done properly. Disadvantages, exchange of information might leave party exposed to competitive strategy, obviously. Because in this very particular case, every party would like to win, or win-win situation is there, you want to solve the problem. So every party is disclosing each and every kind of information to each other. So that can be misused sometimes to use the competitive strategy in future period of time. So these are the various three models which are being used in the organization for the purpose of achieving their targets. All the three models can be used. And this topic negotiation is itself a very important topic, from not only from the exam point of view but also from your career point of view, because you can use this terminology or the strategies or the models in your real career in the organizations while you are doing jobs for the organization or you are running your own organization. So this topic is very, very important and very significant from your point of view. So thank you all. Thank you so much.